Hey everyone, in this new episode of DevOps Lab, we've got Dan Hellem with us, and we're going to dive in and see what's new in Visual Studio 2019. Welcome to the DevOps Lab. Today I'm super excited because for our guest, we have Dan Hellem. Dan?
Thanks, Abel. My name is Dan Hellem. I'm a program manager on the Visual Studio, on the Azure DevOps team, and we're talking here today about the integration that we just redid for Visual Studio 2019.
Yeah, I'm super excited. Visual Studio 2019. Right now we're at what, Preview 3?
Preview 3 is out now, and then we have, I think April 2nd is when Visual Studio goes live for RTM.
Very, very cool. I'm super excited. I've been using Visual Studio for, I think, all my career, so I'm really excited about this. Why don't you tell us some of the new features and new things that's coming in Visual Studio 2019?
Yeah, so let me put it in context a little bit. So if we take a look at like 2015, 2017, we've always had work item integration with that within TFS and now Azure DevOps.
Yep.
And so what we've done is we've kind of pivoted a little bit in 2019. So if we take a look at, again, those older versions, you create queries, you run the queries, you does you all the things that you need to do as a developer to go ahead and find the work items and relate your work to those work items. Mm-hmm. But we found that it's a little, the barrier to entry is a little high, right? So anyone who's coming in who's doing things like .NET Core, it's just too much work to like, what is this query thing? I got to go figure all this query crap out, edit the queries or run them. And so we kind of pivoted a little bit to focus less on kind of query management and just give me a list of my work items, right? Give me the things that are assigned to me. Give me the list of things that maybe I'm following or people have mentioned me. And the idea there is get rid of some of those blockers or roadblocks to get people into it and then just get going. And so that's the kind of the idea.
So it's a simpler path into my work items that are on Azure DevOps.
Exactly. And then the other flip side of that is we're kind of making this journey into modernizing some of our platform. Mm-hmm. And some of that platform is within the integration within Visual Studio is on old tech. And so we're trying to up the tech a little bit and get rid of some of the old junk and get onto the new stuff.
Cool. So I would love to see some of this.
Yeah, good. So let's start with, I have a project. Okay. And if we go ahead and we take a look at that, say, hey, I'm on the home screen. Everything's really the same here, right? I've connected to my Azure DevOps account. I'm going ahead and I've created a project and I'm working on it, et cetera. Mm-hmm. And you'll see here now I have my work items, which is the same as it's always been. And this is a Git project here specifically.
Okay.
So if when I click on work items, you'll hear this is where the experience is different.
Okay.
So here you can see right away, right, is I don't have a query to run. I'm not executing a query, doing anything like that, query management. It just gives me a list of the items that are assigned to me.
Right? Okay.
And I can flip through multiple different types of views, so to speak, right? We have assigned to me, things that I'm following, things that are mentioned, my activity, et cetera. And so the idea here is this kind of directly replicates the my work items that are over in Azure DevOps.
Okay.
And it's basically the same APIs and everything and the same screens that we would go ahead and follow.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so, and what we've done here is we've added different filters on top of the views. So for example, here you can see I got like close items, right? So as an engineer and I'm working on new stuff, I probably don't care about the close stuff anymore, right? So I can go ahead and just say, you know what, let's just go ahead and hide the close ones.
Cool.
And I'll go ahead and obviously give me a view of missing or with the close items removed. The other thing we've done too is here, as you can see, we have a bunch of work items where if I want to do like quick editing, I can do that. We're not going to make like a full blown editing experience. The idea is go over to the web, do it in there. But if I want to go ahead and quickly maybe assign something to somebody else, I can do so. I can go ahead and change a state. If I want to change a state, so if I want to go ahead and make this active or close or whatever it might be, whatever state it is that work item's in, and I can also do quick editing on the item itself. And the idea here there is just, it's simple, right? We don't want to do a bunch of management of work items. We just want to get our work done. If we have to make some minor edits, so be it. We'll do that right inside of the UI. Another thing we've added here too is and this isn't really new, is we can go ahead and create work items directly from Visual Studio.
Okay.
But again, the experience is super simple. So if I want to create like a new user story, really all I have to do is put in the title and create it, and then I'm done.
Oh, nice.
So that's all it is.
So much simpler than before.
Yeah, so much easier than before. Now, the only downside is if you're a complex process and that kind of thing has a bunch of rules, it's going to bark at you to say, hey, you can't create it here. You got to go into the web, create it, and it'll directly take you right into the web so you can create the work item there.
Got it.
But for the 90% of people who don't do a bunch of crazy rules on their work items, I can just enter the title and it'll be done with it.
Fantastic.
Yep. The other thing that we've done too is another view here where you can see where I have a bunch of things like, you know, you can see the status and or the state of the work item and who's assigned to. A lot of people don't care about all that information because I already know what the stuff is. It's mine. I don't really care about it. So we basically reduced it to a view called this view.
Okay.
So you can see here now it's nice and concise. It's quick. It's easy. That kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Some new features that we've added is as if I want to go ahead now. So here I have some work that I maybe want to change, and I'm working on this particular item. I can go ahead here and create a new branch directly from a work item.
Oh, nice.
So here I'll just type in, we'll just do users. Dan, and we'll do a test. So we go ahead and we create that branch. What that does, it actually creates the branch, relates the work item directly to that branch. So now as I start doing work, and when I do my check, my commit later on, it already has it associated.
That's fantastic.
So that's kind of a nice new feature.
Yeah.
So here, you kind of see that there. I don't have any changes yet, but you can see that it's directly related.
So we used to have this experience in from the Kanban boards on the UI of Azure DevOps.
Yes.
So now you guys have brought that into Visual Studio.
Yeah, but the difference is that actually created a server-side branch. This one here is just local branch. On my machine. I've created my quick branch that I want to do from master or whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
And now I go ahead and do my work, and then I'll end up doing my commit, my pull request, and that kind of thing later.
Fantastic. Right.
So if I come back in here too, another nice new feature too is we've added is as I'm going through my work items, I can go ahead and quickly say, you know what, let's relate to changes. So what that does is it quickly relates the work item to the work that I'm working on.
Oh,
and
nice.
So when I do my commit, there again, it's already associated.
Nice, nice.
So let's go ahead and make a quick change here. I'm just going to remove some code real quick.
Okay.
Pretty straightforward. We'll come in here now. If I come into my, let's go ahead and save it. And I come into my changes, and you can see now I've got those two work items. They're associated to my change that I made. And let's say for some reason maybe there's other work items that I want to do for, right? So now I can come in here and say, let's just do a pound, and we can do an at mention, or pound mention, and you can see now from the list is we now have a list of all the work items that are, again, associated to me or associated to my search here. So if I want to say just release, right, it'll give me everything that has the word release in it. And now I can quickly add work items and associate those to the commit as well, directly from the at mentions.
Cool, cool, very cool.
And let's go ahead and add one more here, just so you can kind of see it in action. And so as I'm adding them, it directly throws them directly inside of related work items, and I'm ready to go, right? And so now I'll just put in some commit language, whatever it is, and we'll do a commit. And now if we want to go ahead and do a push, there it goes.
Nice.
Nice and fast. If I come in here now to my pull requests,
and we'll see it here.
You should be able to go ahead and create a pull request, and now you're going to see all those work items that were associated to this particular pull request for this particular commit.
Nice. Right.
Okay. That's kind of like the general experience. I think in general, like those are the changes that we made. Again, we streamlined it quite a bit for developers to say, look, give me the things that I'm focused on.
Yep.
And don't bother me with all this query craziness.
I've got to admit this. When I first started playing with Visual Studio 2019, this change in the work items, this was kind of jarring for me because I already had queries all set up. I knew exactly what to do. I've been using this forever. But now that you've shown me how to use the new work item experience in VS 2019, you're right. This is super streamlined. This is really nice.
Yeah, super streamlined. And actually, to get to your point, like, queries were great for if I had like a bunch of different conditions to go find work items all over the place, right? And people would use queries to go ahead and do things like manage and plan their sprints and those kinds of things. And we kind of like let's get out of that, right? If you want to go do that, go do it to the web.
Makes perfect sense.
Let's go ahead and do it here. And then actually, we also have a search experience here, though, for if there is this work item that's randomly sitting out there that you need to go take a look at that's not in your other list, so you can use a search experience up here as well.
So I still can search for work items.
You can still search for work items across your entire project. Doesn't matter who they're assigned to, that kind of thing. You can just do a quick search. So for example, I can just do a quick like title search if I just want to do like, I think I have like an RC2 type item. It'll go ahead and search the entire project and pull that up.
Nice.
There's also other searching that you can do, like different conditions where you can do, show me all the assigned to Abel were created by Dan or a particular state or a particular work item type. So for example, if I want to show me like all the bugs that are out there, I can do so, right?
So the searching
should give people what they need
instead
of using queries, and that's the hope anyway.
Yes, yes. Gotta say, I love this new streamlined experience. Right?
Awesome.
This is great.
Awesome.
So call to actions. We want developers, right? Download this preview. Start using it. RTM is right around the corner,
yep.
April.
April 2nd, I believe, is when the RTM.
So there's no more new features that are going to be rolled in, right? Just bug fixes. So download this, start using this, and give us feedback. How are we supposed to get feedback back to the VS?
Yeah, so we're going to do something a little bit different. I want people just to contact me directly. Right?
Fantastic.
So go ahead and you can hit my Twitter page. People can go ahead and just hit that, send me a message directly. Yep. You can see here I'm at Dan Hellem. What we want to do is eventually, like the old legacy way is going to go away completely, right?
Yeah.
Especially for Git projects.
So you're talking about for work items.
For work items, right? Okay. So the whole legacy way of doing things with queries and that kind of thing, that's going to go away. And we found that people still like that, but they're not providing us the feedback for us to make changes to the new view. And we're going to eventually have the new one is going to take over completely. So we want people to send us feedback as much as you can. Let us know what you like, what you don't like, how we can improve it so we can make it awesome and so that people love it when we get into like Visual Studio 2020.
Awesome, so. Awesome. Thank you so much, Dan. Developers, download this, start using this. Please give us feedback so, like Dan said, we can make this awesome. And thank you all so much.
Cool. Thanks, Abel.